And now for a special edition of This Day in History. When it comes to America and the Super Bowl, two things are certain. There's gonna be pizza, and there's gonna be lots of over-the-top commercials. People might not remember who played from year to year and the final scores, but they do remember the commercials. That wasn't always the case. On January 22nd, 1984, during Super Bowl XVIII, Steve Jobs released a commercial for the Apple II that completely changed how ads were created. We take our technology today for granted, but in 1984, computers were much more for techies and not the everyday person. Steve Jobs wanted to change this and introduce a computer that could find a place in every home in America. He wanted it to not only be more user-friendly and powerful, but he also wanted it to be meant for the masses. Apple's competition way back when was IBM. They started out making computers intended for big users like government agencies and big corporations, not families. And even when they did come up with a personal computer, it consisted of lots of parts. Jobs' Apple II computer combined a graphical user interface, built-in screen and mouse, all in one place, and much more user-friendly than IBM. So this is what Steve Jobs did to take away business from IBM. He hired an ad agency which was willing to go big or go home. Together, they took the theme from a book written in 1949 about a future when the government or Big Brother had total control. That book was called 1984 by George Orwell, and the ad was slated to air during Super Bowl XVIII. The ad was shot in black and white and featured zombies, like drones, listening to Big Brother until a rebellious woman outruns the thought police and throws her sledgehammer into a screen that was showing Big Brother. Jobs loved the concept, but his board hated it. They also hated the idea of spending $800,000 of their precious dollars for two ad spots during the big game. But the ad stayed. 96 million people watched it that Sunday and said they had never seen anything like it. And they hadn't, because unlike every other ad of the time, it never even showed the product. But the ad created lots of demand for the computer, which debuted 2 days after on January 24th. Jobs wanted to sell people on something they didn't even know they wanted, and this ad did just that. The Super Bowl is always a big event, but after the 1984 ad, other companies now save their very best for the big game, knowing how important it is to deliver a hit. If you think this looks familiar, then you're right. This ad gets parodied a lot, and Fortnite even did a parody of it in 2020. Here's a clip of the original 1984 ad. To see the entire ad, use the QR code at the end of the show, because obviously we can't show the whole ad due to copyright reasons.
Is more powerful a weapon than any fleet or army on earth. We are one people, with one will, one resolve, one cause. Our enemies shall talk themselves to death, and we will bury them with their own confusion.
Thanks for watching, CMSW. If you didn't get a chance to scan the QR code with your phone, click right there, or scan right there. See you next time on CMSW Studio.